When creating a simulation, it can sometimes be difficult to keep track of what settings are applied to which parts of your model geometry. Instead of directly selecting geometric entities in the various physics settings, for example, boundary conditions, material assignments, or mesh settings, you can prepare explicit selections in advance to name one or more geometric entities with a label you find meaningful. In COMSOL Multiphysics, explicit selections are used to create selections of individual geometric entities for any chosen geometry level. This selection tool helps organize your model setup so that relations between the different parts of your model and what conditions and constraints apply to each are completely transparent and easy to follow. It also makes setting up simulations more effective, since a selection of entities only needs to be made once and can then be reused in any materials, physics, meshing, or post-processing nodes. So here we have the shell and tube heat exchanger tutorial model opened up, and this is a multiphysics model that couples turbulent flow and heat transfer. In this model, we have two fluids, air and water, that pass through the heat exchanger at different temperatures and in opposite directions. The water flows through the tubes, and the air flows through the shell. To set up this simulation, we're going to make several selections of entities that can then be reused for any of the materials, mesh, physics, and even post-processing nodes. So you can add an explicit selection two ways. You can right-click the geometry node, go under selections, and then add it there, or go under the geometry tab in the ribbon, click the selections button, and add it here. So explicit selections differ from other selection types in that geometric entities are selected as the input entities. So you can think of an explicit selection as a container for selected geometric entities that you can label to your liking. So for our first explicit selection, we want to create a selection of just the water domain. So let's rename that appropriately. So renaming the label really helps organize the model. It's easier to recognize than the default naming convention of explicit 1 or explicit 2. It's also important since the label shows up in the materials, physics, or mesh settings. So it'll make it easier for us to recognize and then select from that respective node's drop-down list. So now that I've changed the label, I choose the level of geometry I want, which is set to domain, which is perfect. And then I can select, and there we've added our first explicit selection. Let's also do this for the air domain. So again, I'm going to rename that, leave the geometry level set to domain, and then select the air domain. So thus far, we've only created explicit selections with a single geometric entity in each, but remember that you can select multiple entities. So let's show how we can actually make selecting multiple entities much faster. Here we are going to create a selection of all of the boundaries lying on the XZ plane. So we can rename this selection symmetry, change the geometry level to boundary, and then we can go ahead and start selecting those boundaries. But instead of clicking each one individually like you see I'm doing, we can actually use the select box feature to select all of these boundaries at once. So I'll switch to the YZ plane view and then use the select box. And you can see we've selected all of those boundaries very quickly and easily. We can also make selecting several entities even more efficient by using the group by continuous tangent option. So I'll clear the selection again and just select a single boundary. So this feature automatically selects all adjacent boundaries at an angle less than the value we specify for the angular tolerance. The angular tolerance sets the condition for what boundaries will be included. So this is the maximum angle we can have between two faces or edges, and it must be between 0 and 180 degrees or 0 and pi radians. It also works for curved boundaries. So now let's make another explicit selection, this time for the inlet of the water domain. So we can rename this to the inlet for the water, change the geometry level to boundary, and choose that boundary. And we'll do the same with the outlet. Move around the geometry, select it, and we have those set up. Let's also do that for the air domain, but instead of creating new ones, I can simply duplicate, change the label, clear the selection, and then select that inlet boundary. So the duplicate feature can quickly replicate selections that we can use to make new ones from with a few minor adjustments. So let's do this also for the outlet of the air domain. Change the label. Just clear that up and select the boundary we want. So now because I've set up these selections already, I can go through and easily apply them to any of the settings in my model. Here I have already added some material settings and boundary conditions to this model, and now I just have to select the geometric entities they should apply to. The material air we want to assign to the air domain, so I can just go ahead and select air domain. I can do the same with the water material. I can assign that to the water domain. And for any of my physics settings I already have here or any ones I want to add, those selections I previously created are always available. For the inlet boundary condition, I can apply it to the water domain's inlet and do the same with the outlet, as well as the same logic for the air, applying those boundary conditions to the explicit selections that we've created, and apply the symmetry boundary condition to our symmetry explicit selection. So now you can see how selecting geometry in the graphics window and creating those selections earlier in our model setup really streamlines the rest of the modeling workflow. We can simply just select from the drop-down list any of our selections and apply any type of settings that we need. So please note that depending on how the geometry was created and what type of changes were made to it, explicit selections can keep and correctly update their content in many cases. Exceptions to this are re-importing a geometry from a file. For example, if we were to re-import an updated heat exchanger geometry here, and also if the operations in the geometry sequence are updated in a way that would, for example, result in the addition of new entities. There are other selection tools for ensuring that the selections maintain their content in these cases, such as coordinate-based selections. So now you can see the several advantages of using explicit selections in your model. You can collect the selections into one location in the model and make it easy for someone else to understand your model setup. Also, the selections can be used anywhere throughout the model, such as for the materials, physics, mesh, results, and other definitions. In addition, we reviewed updating the label of the selection, the special options available depending on the geometry level, and how to easily recreate selections by using the duplicate feature.